Hello, Reformers, and welcome back to Nova Aetas. Now, when we left off, we had just defended... now I remember. Oh, the nightmare of Mithridius. Yes, defending that is very, very difficult because the enemies don't want to die. They just want to stand on the siege ladder and just sit there for all eternity, which I don't really mind because obviously it makes it a little bit easier to actually take zero casualties, but still, the point is, not very good. Anyway, I have returned back to our town, our main town, that is. Yes, I did buy some tools, but I haven't found any bolts of velvet or anything to actually change my court location. So that's a bit of a problem, but yeah, anyway, I've come across the ocean, and we now have this fellow. He is age 27. He is disloyal and unbelievably fat, apparently. Okay, deadly leader. Oh, yes. Very bad supplier of required food and beverages. This captain leads people to death. Well, that's not very good. Okay, I'm probably not going to take him then. And Lexei? Do I have him? I actually pledged an oath. No, he is actually one of ours, apparently. Did he? I think so. Oh no, they actually all did. Okay, never mind. Okay, so that does not help me in the least. Okay, so there are a couple of them that need to go away. I'm going to see which ones they are, of course. But, yes. For now, I think it's just a good idea to head into the hall and see what's going on here, so... Yeah, we have a huge amount of money with our kingdom at the moment. Aha, okay, so, yes, I'm not going to be accepting you. Or am I? He actually has a very good relation. Maybe I should accept him? See, this is the thing. If I accept him, then it's just going to make things even worse with the other lords. Because he is a different religion to them, and it's... We saw what happened with the High Jarl Valsafor, didn't we? So I'm going to say no. He's going to the Turgon Horde now, which I suppose is okay. I'm going to try and make an alliance with them at some point as well, but I don't think that's going to happen anytime soon. Ah, this fellow, he has minus 20. He doesn't like us very much. And this guy has minus one. He is from King Cedrus. That's Swedia. Alright, so let's take a look here. So, Do I want to grant anyone a fief? No, I do not, apparently. Apparently everyone has one or something along those lines. I would like to issue an edict. And I'm going to make it so that we have a little bit more commoner power. Because that usually makes things a little bit better. And court treasurer. So we have 954,000 right now, okay? So this is going to be pretty insane. Let's invest another 5% in the kingdom. That sounds good to me. And we're also going to... I'm not going to do anything there, but do I need to change anything here? That's the thing. Do I need to change anything here? I don't think so. And one of you actually did state in the comments if... demoting them in rank actually has any effect on them apart from the relation or apart from how much money they take. I can't remember your comment exactly, but yeah, I actually don't know that. So if anyone else has the answer, then by all means, let us know. So let's send an official letter to that fellow to improve our relations a little bit. Let's send some money to that guy. And yes, This is good. Okay, so, yeah. Now, there is actually something that I wanted to mention, and that is the fact that Theoden is an absolute beast. He is really good. He has a huge amount of units in his army, and I'm actually really surprised about that, because usually, you know, that's usually not how it goes, you know? Usually you gain a guy, and he's not really very good. Now, as you can see here, Valsafor is actually not bad. He has 124, and I'm actually kind of sad that he has a really bad relation with us, but it's going to take so much money to get him in a positive relation now, so probably not going to do that. But as you can see, Theoden has 184, really nice. Devlian also has a really large amount of units, so I'm really happy about that. So what we're going to do is we're going to level up Matteld here, get her some more strength, get her some more shield, and we need to get her some Weapon Master, I think, do we? No, she has 3 in Weapon Master right now. That's pretty decent. Okay, well, anyway, as you can see here, we currently still do not have our money. So I'm thinking that I'm probably going to wait here for some time. I'm going to just see what happens, because we're going to be paid soon. Very, very soon, in fact. And we're going to see what happens, because obviously I'd like to make our archers a little bit better, you know? Ah, there we are. That's there it is. It's coming in now. That's really nice. Okay, so Marigi is currently being defeated all the time, and I think I might replace him as Marshal. So we might be doing that soon. So, yes, let's probably go in and... No, I don't want to do that just yet. Thank you very much. I'd like to go to the hall. Yes, there we are. Okay, so, yeah, we're going to replace him as Marshal, and we're going to make Theoden the new Marshal, because it seems like he has the biggest army. And I know that this is going to make Marigi a little bit upset, but that is just how things have to be. So let's replace him and give... Where is it? Theoden. There we are. Oh, he didn't go down. He didn't go down in relation. Well, that's actually really quite impressive. Okay, I actually thought that Marigi was certainly going to go down, but apparently not. Apparently not. Okay, so I'm pretty happy about that, and we now have the opportunity to change our unit's equipment, which is fantastic. So let's remove all of these things. Let's actually just take all of this off here. There we go, and now we will be giving them some really nice stuff. Oh yes, look at that. Okay, so where's my chest piece? There it is. And large bag of arrows. And where's the bodkin arrows? I'd like to put the bodkin arrows on there first. Where are they? Oh, they're in there. Oh, okay, they're still in there. Oh, that's hilarious. Okay, so, yes, my bad. Okay, so large bag, a two-handed axe or rusty rapier. I'm actually unsure what to give them, because I don't have a shield right now, so I guess I'll just give them the two-handed axe. And give them the war bow as well. And that's it, right? That is it, as far as I'm aware. That seems to be it. There we go. Okay, so yes, just pay whatever you can. That's great. There we go. And yes, there we are. Okay, so now, there are our new archers. Oh yes, this is going to be absolutely amazing. Now, obviously they don't really have very good stats. They have pretty terrible, awful stats, but their power draw is pretty reasonable. And I've given them a new bow, and they have a two-handed axe, so hopefully they'll be able to be reasonable in melee combat as well. So, let's execute this guy while we're at it. You do not deserve leniency. No, you certainly do not. Okay, well, there we go. That is it. That is a little bit of kingdom management there. And we're also going to now be heading back over the ocean. As long as no one else decides to defect to us, because that has happened many times. And hopefully our next kingdom wages will not be affected by that too much. Okay, so I probably still need to colonize many of these places, but right now it's kind of pointless because I don't really have any opportunity to do that. Now what I can do is I can technically go into Mithridius's marketplace and get some armor and stuff for our noble herdsmen. So yeah, we might try to do that, but oh. Yes, Vochenik Clay of the Vagia Sardom has been indicted for treason. What a wonderful thing indeed, because now he has apparently fled to us. Oh, and another one from the Vagias. Oh, this is just terrible, isn't it? It's so annoying when that happens. Okay, so who's this? Who is attempting to raid our... Oh, hello there. This is the guy that we just declined the pledge of, which is kind of hilarious in itself. Okay, so we're going to go over here. And we're going to take him out. Yes, get him. There we go. You won't regret your decision to give this to you? What? I didn't give you anything. Thank you very much. Okay, we're going to crush him. Because I feel as though it is necessary to try out our archers. We only have 20 of them. But I feel as though a smaller scale battle like this is going to give us a good idea of how effective they can be, of course. Or not. As the case may be, because now we are just having these guys charge us, which is kind of disappointing. But obviously we have archers with big two-handed axes, so I wouldn't be surprised if our veteran archers actually kill more than the Huskarls now, which is going to be pretty impressive. It seems like that might be partially it. No, some of them. They're actually sharing the kills relatively well, so that's always nice. That's always nice. You know, sharing is caring after all. Right? Anyway, let's try and take him out. There we go. And that's it. Yes, that was very, very easy indeed, of course. And no deaths and no casualties, should we say, on our side at all. And I'm just hopeful that our archers will do a really good job. Ooh, look at that spin. Did you see that spin that guy did when he died? Oh, that was fantastic. Okay, so, yes. That will be it, and there are still just two enemies remaining. They are actually running away. Are they actually running away? That is terrible. Oh no, they're cannoneers, aren't they? They are probably cannoneers. That's probably the reason why they're running away, because they don't have any weapons. And they're actually just standing here. So that is kind of... Yep, there we go. They do have weapons. They do have a cannon. But they haven't fired it, so... Goodbye. Goodbye, sir. And where is the other one? Is the other one over here somewhere? Yes, one of our other companions is assaulting him right now. Could you kill him, please? What are you doing? You're just running away from a person with no weapon? Okay, that's kind of weird. Oh. Hilarious ragdoll right there. Yes. Okay, so, yes, there we are. That is it. We can take him prisoner, and I do know what I'm going to be doing with him. Thank you very much. Yes. Immediately going to be executing him for betraying us so incredibly quickly. I mean, he just renounced his allegiance, or technically didn't renounce it, but we declined his allegiance, and then he comes immediately here to attack us. I'm very irritated by that. Okay, well, anyway. I think we're okay right now with this, so shall we try and take Hierosolyma? It seems like that might be the only option for us right now. The only other thing we can do is take Zendar. I don't really care about that guy, so I'm just going to leave him, as, you know, we do have a couple of vassals in the area, I think. That might be the case, I'm not too sure. And then we're just going to head over to Zendar and see what's going on there, because I'd very much like to take this. Accompanying. Why are you accompanying me? As you can see, he's accompanying us, and he's from Swadia, so that's kind of weird, isn't it? Okay, so disembark. Okay, so what am I besieging this? Apparently I'm just besieging this. Okay. Yeah, okay. Well, that didn't work out too well, did it? Apparently the SARRANIDs have a bone to pick with us. Hilariously enough, and this is actually the Sultan himself. The Sultan himself. I actually don't know why he's here. I don't know why he's here, but okay. Okay, we're going to be tackling these guys. We have minus 5 battle advantage. They have 103, which is a bit ouch. Yes, a bit ouch. And we have 52. So I guess we're just going to have to try our very best, aren't we? Alright, so I was attempting to get our forces not here. Yeah, I was actually attempting to get them on the hill behind us over there, to the side slightly. But, yeah, as you can see, that has not worked out too well, has it? No, hasn't worked out too well. So, we're going to have a little bit of a problem on our hands here. Because, yeah, these guys are actually pretty decent. The SARRANID horsemen are not something to be too worried about, but they are quite difficult to take out. And we have advanced to level 36. Very nice. That's not too bad. So, yes, other than that, I think we're just going to try and eliminate these guys, and then we're going to hold position and maybe wait for their infantry to come in here, because I don't really want to venture too far away from our spawn zone, because if we do that, we are going to be at a major disadvantage. And I'm going to be cutting away and doing all kinds of editing trickery here because I don't really want to show waiting for them. Oh! Apparently Matteld ran into the enemy infantry. Well, I must commend her for bravery, but not so much for self-preservation. And also Quinius. Quinius, what are you doing? You cannot do such a thing. Ah, well, doesn't matter too much, as you can see. Come on now, I think we could... Can you charge? Can you charge, guys? Are you going to charge in or no? Okay, well, I'm going to tell our archers to hold position back there. Thank you very much. And we're then going to see what happens. We have received more enemy reinforcements. And they are actually attempting to run away. They're attempting to skirmish with us, even though they don't really have any ranged units. That's kind of a bit weird. I suppose they're trying to just save as many of their forces as they can, which is... absolutely fine. I mean, yes, you can kind of expect that to happen. I'm going to heal our forces once again if I can. There we go. That's good. And maybe... Do I need to run away here? Do I need to retreat a little bit? I don't think so. I mean, that's the thing. How can I do that if we are just going to then continually be attacked? Okay, so I'm going to need to get my archers over here. Because, I mean, if I just allow them to reimburse themselves and to reinforce their position, then... isn't that a bad thing? Maybe. Maybe not. I don't know, actually. Right now, it seems actually that we're doing a pretty reasonable job of things, so I don't think we really need to worry about it. But I'm just so incredibly surprised that the Saranids attempted to, well, basically intercept us, in comparison to Zendar actually attempting to do that. So, I am very disappointed in the Sultan. I thought we had an understanding that I was not going to besiege Hierosolyma until it had been taken by the Crusades. Of course, I'm just kidding. But, point is, yeah, a little bit weird, isn't it? A little bit weird that the Saranids are looking out for their Zendarian cousins. Yeah, they're not technically cousins or anything related to them, but still, I find that very weird. Okay, so we've lost a grand total of 9, then they have lost a grand total of 140. We are going to lose a lot more now, though, because we have these guys. Yes, these guys. This is just great, isn't it? Oh, yes. Muskets as well, and they're going to go through shields, as far as I'm aware. They go through shields, the muskets, so that's kind of a bit worrying, but I'm going to try and interrupt them as much as I can. Slaughter them all! Yes, there we go. At least I am distracting them. As long as I can distract them, that is all that matters, because our forces will be able to then easily deal with their infantry. As far as I'm aware, that is the best tactic, because right now, our infantry are so much better than theirs, and the only thing that we have as a weakness is ranged units, technically. So, if I can eliminate all of these, or at least try to distract them as much as possible, then I will have done my job, and we will be in a very, very strong position to continue attacking. Now, if these guys are an example of the Saranids as a whole, because obviously the Sultan himself is here, then obviously I think we might even have a great chance to take Hierosolyma as it is. I mean, as you can see here, I mean, we've eliminated so many and only lost 13, and this is just a testament to the Huskarls, and they're not even wearing the best armor. I could give them my armor, technically. I could take their armor, put it on myself, and I could give them my armor, and then, of course, they would be even better. But I don't know. I don't think that's a good idea, really, because even though it would make a huge difference to them, I think it would then spoil some of the sort of atmosphere that we have going right now, because obviously we are technically the king, and, you know, we're wearing king armor, so it kind of makes a difference. But anyway, there we have it. That's actually rather nice. 32 renown, 35 morale, and they only have 160 remaining, which is hilarious. Alright, so we have a little bit of a situation here. We are on either side of a kind of valley sort of environmental obstacle here, and the Dagnabia veteran archers are actually doing a pretty reasonable job right now. They have only killed one unit so far, and they are shooting, as far as I'm aware. Or are they? Because some of them aren't actually shooting, hilariously enough. I'm not actually unsure why that would be, but okay. And I think we should probably just charge in, because there doesn't seem to be anything else that we can do here. And we are being pelted by muskets. And we don't really want that to happen, do we? So I'm going to just try and interrupt them a little bit here. Yes, kill them! Don't get stopped, though, Diggory! We cannot allow it! We cannot allow that. There we go. They're all staying in a very nice, tight little package here, aren't they? A package of death. They're going to be receiving that, aren't they? Yes, very much going to be receiving that. So, yes, otherwise I think I just need to heal our forces after a little couple of seconds, you know. Need to make sure that they all stay alive. And come on, kill him! Yes, there we go. New enemies have arrived, but I don't think we really need to worry about that at all. I mean, this is the thing. We now have the, well, I was about to say we have the trifecta, but I suppose we have the difecta. If you want to have some weird wordplay going on there. But anyway, point is, we have archers and infantry now. And that means that we have no weakness, technically. Technically no weakness, if you can consider heavy cavalry maybe a weakness. Because if they swing around and actually deal damage to our archers, then that can be very, very harsh, you know, and we might actually have that happen in the future if we are against Swadia at some point, because obviously they do have an overabundance of cavalry, and their cavalry is some of the best. So we do need to be a little bit careful of that, and I also need to be careful of staying alive, so let's heal myself a little bit here. Let's put our archers over there as well. Maybe we can put our archers at the top of this hill here, Oh, they're going to attack the skirmisher division. Oh, well, that's... I guess that's okay. As you can see, these javelineers are, of course, the skirmishers that the game speaks of. Oh, we lost a huskarl. A couple of huskarls. Really? Ah. Well, that is just preposterous. Absolutely awful. Okay, well, let me just heal them. There we go. Oh, who's that? What are you doing over there? You seem to be running around like headless chickens. I don't know why you're doing that. That's a little bit weird. Okay. Well, I don't really mind so much because victory is ours. Victory. And there it is. Okay, so that's pretty good. We have defeated the Sultan of the Sarranids. And if I'm able to take him prisoner, that would be fantastic. But no, not able to take him prisoner. So a little bit disappointing. Let's take them prisoner because we want to gain a little bit of honor back. Do we want to gain honor back? I don't think it's worth it, to be honest. But anyway, let's take some veterans. And I now have a full party. Thing is, noble herdsmen, I don't really need them right now. So I'm going to lose a couple. Going to take the heavy infantry. And are there any veteran archers here? No, there are no veteran archers. So I suppose I should probably just take them back. And there we have it. That sounds good to me. All right, so let's take a look here. So there's actually a couple of people heading our way now, which is really kind of sad. I think we maybe would have been able to do this before the Zendarian armies even appeared. But apparently the Sarranids had other ideas. So I thank you very much for watching, and I will see you next time.